The air bubbles in the battery was bothering me. I didn't sleep last night because of those bubbles. So I mixed small amount of this epoxy and I will make thin layer. But yeah, let's see how it will go.
Okay, check what I got here. I have the syncos sensors, and this means that I can install these to the motor and maybe take some test drive with the bike. Nice.
I have now installed the sensor here, the new sensor which John just sent me or week ago, but I just got it. And I have made the basic setting, set the minimum amount of wires here so I can test the actual setup if it will spin. And I will change these screws here, but I made this kind of metal blade here so it should keep the ignition switch on the right place. So, ignition on, click, contactor went on, then drive forward and it should run. I don't know what happens. I have set 14 newton meters torque. No. So, what the fuck? Okay, so last night went quite long. I wasn't able to get motor spinning with my test setup. And I didn't have my laptop in my garage, so I came here this morning and checked what might be wrong because Sevcon is not giving any faults and everything seems to work. There is no smoke, which is a good thing. And I noticed I have peak torque 0 Nm, so 40 Nm. Let's see if it's running now. It's fucking awesome. It's fucking awesome. Yeah, we are back again. Yep, bike is now running, motor is spinning, rear tire is spinning also, jack shaft is working. But there is, let's say, five things I still need to do. And the first one is the primary gear and the chain. So I cannot tighten this chain so much that it would be good. This is too much to tighten up. So I will make one teeth bigger front sprocket. So then it will be quite tight. And I will do spring-loaded tensioner on the one, just on one side. Then the other thing is the air filter box. I still need to do the blade over here. So that's also the priority one tasks, so I can get this wiring harness properly installed. And after those two things are done, then I can mount. I need to repaint the battery. It's not necessary and important thing, but I want to repaint and put some graphics on it so it will look a little bit better. And on the left-hand side, I need to add the metal U bracket here. Under the plastic, it will protect protect the feet a little bit more, and also the battery box cover needs to be printed out. And then after those I can make the first test runs with the bike. But yeah, then I can test drive the bike, and if everything works and it runs fine, then I will install all the necessary things for liquid cooling, and after that I can ramp up the current and push it to the limits. But yeah, not too much job to do and not any hard tasks, mainly just nice fine-tuning. So I have now removed all the wires here. I have removed the battery, which was very easy to lift off. I will lose this bolt and take this off so I can tilt the subframe a little bit lower. Then I start to assemble or make the plastic cover over there. Boom. Installed the cable holders here, and now I'm making some holes that I can attach this plate against the air filter box. Next. So I have now everything here. I have screws, bolts, nuts, washers, everything. I'm removing the bolts. Setting the first one. Good. Now this air filter box should have strength like it has when it was new. I have now installed the protective cover, and I thought I could print something here so it will look a little bit nicer. But now if there's some needs to change the sensor or whatever, it's easy to remove just the small cover instead of taking the whole plate off. And I have tightened the sprocket screw, and like I earlier said, I will add the aluminium plate here so it can take a little bit of the forces if the chain will broke or anything. And this should be installed over here, but I need to check if I need to change the bolts.
I think these are just good.
Under a bit. Not too tight because there is aluminium thread against this steel screw. Yep. So I like it. Next thing, I will install the cables to the inverter and I will install the rear subframe. I have now made all three motor phase wire and I try to put those through from those holders here. Temporary testing wires can be removed now and I can concentrate on the right ones. I'm going to use this kind of protective caps over these phase wires. This good. Then I just trying to slide this protective cap over here. It's actually quite good. I found these from eBay. Something like 1 euro per piece. So it's not too bad. It's quite nice looking setup. I will tighten this. I have tightened these here. And the link cables will come in from here. Those will be quite much bigger cable. So that's how the Sevcon's box is looking right now. Then I will lift up the subframe so I can see if there is something I miss. Air filter box, all the cables are going quite nicely through these kind of holders, don't know what those in English, but and this cable will be tied over here. I will turn this little bit so it will be directly pointing to backwards. Then I can tie the cable nicely over here. Then this area is ready, but now I should think how I will take my wiring harness to the front section of the bike. But let's see how much space does the cables have when they are coming through over there. That's quite nice. And I will lift up the cables from here and connecting those to battery. So I have now made the 1/5 bigger front sprocket. This was the first version and actually it's a little bit better with 1/5 bigger front sprocket. I have more space to weld the spacers for both sides. But yeah, now change lap is quite good even without the tensioner, but I have here just placed the chain cord. I have printed it and yeah, it should work. I don't know if it's strong enough, but I will install here the aluminium plate against the chain guard, so it should handle
the forces. And here you can see the guides for the chain. Those will go against the rolls. So it should work.
So I have now 3D printed the cable holders. But first thing what I need to do, I will measure the insulation resistance of this material because I didn't find any electrical properties from the datasheet. So 1000 volts and just checking between the pots if there is some voltage going through. Yeah, nothing. So the measurement device shows 5.5 gigaohms with 1000 volts, so it's strong go. Okay, so the printed part looks like this. There is slide rows on the both sides, and I'm going to install it here between the motor blades. I will slide it here. Then I will cut the cables here, put the connectors, and then I will install the upper plate. So, should work. Now I will drop this cover here, like this, and I need to find the right screws here, but for me it looks very good. Very good. Now the phase bars are installed, and next thing I can drop the battery. I have now assembled the bike, and basically it's ready for first test ride. I still have few things which are missing, like the cover and also the water cooling, and I need to get more this kind of protective insulating thing to the cables, and this is temporary, just holding the cables here. But not much work left, but now it's time to test ride it. This is a little bit warm, but still colder than hand. So, quite good feeling about the bike. Okay, so first test ride is now done. Bike runs very well, and in next episode I'm concentrating to make the quad over here, and also finalizing the water cooling and also the wiring. There is few things still are not finalized regarding the wiring. Okay, thank you for watching, and hope see you next week.